In this video lecture, we're going to focus on atmospheric pressure. Now, pressure is the weight exerted on an object by the atmosphere. The atmosphere is weighing down on us and is a result of gravity, the Earth spinning. There are differences in pressure, and the differences in pressure are based on the surface heating. Some locations will have a great deal of surface heating, other locations do not. Air naturally wants to balance. It will fill in the voids, but those voids are due to changes in heating at the surface. So let's talk about how pressure results. All right, we have temperature, and if we take two columns of air that are the same height, and we change their temperature, what we get is, if we cool this one down, this column of air down, this column will shrink. It will shrink because it becomes more dense. It becomes more dense. More dense. Therefore, it sinks. Very important to identify. Cool column of air becomes more dense and it sinks. So instead of having this height of a column, what we get is a smaller column of sinking air. On the other hand, we have this column of air. We are going to warm it up. We're going to warm it up. It becomes less dense. And has a rising effect. Warm air rises. A hot air balloon rises. So it rises from the surface. Instead of the original column of air, we get a taller column of air. So the density here, this size of column is more dense. All the air molecules are pushed in together. They're compressed because it's cool and has a sinking. It weighs more and sinks toward the surface. On the other hand, these air molecules are spread out because now they're warm. And so what you get, a column of air that expands upward and has a rising effect. So what is the pressure associated here? Well, we get cool air, more dense, it weighs more, and sinks. We create a high pressure at the surface. On the other hand, you have warm air that is less dense and rises, you create a low pressure at the surface. If we start with a high pressure at the surface, the air is packed in. If we look, this is at the surface, and then let's draw a cross section here. We're gonna lengthen this. Here's the cross section. Remember from the previous lecture, we looked at this column of air, the sinking air because it's cool and it is more dense. That air is constantly feeding toward the surface, or is moving toward the surface, is sinking toward the surface. Therefore, it results in a high pressure. On the other side of this, you have a tall column of air that is the result of warmer air that's rising, and it's creating a void at the surface. So where is the air going? The air goes from sinking air to an area that it wants to fill. Here, there's a lot of air. There's a lot of air associated with this point, this location. And so what we get is the air's packing in. Now it wants to find room. It wants to go to a location where there's very little air. And so it will find a void. The void is to move toward this area here where there is a void at the surface due to the rising air. Due to the rising air. Therefore, as we go from a high pressure to the low pressure, the winds increase in speed because they're like, I'm finding a void. I'm going to fill that void very quickly. So you go from this point, the high pressure, to the low pressure, increasing that speed. Now think of it like a construction site. This is a construction site. it's a two-lane highway, okay, going one direction. You come upon a construction site that asks you to merge. What happens when you have to merge? What happens to that traffic, especially when you've got semis? Everybody's got to get into this spot. So what is the pressure here? It's the same thing as sinking air. The pressure at this point is a high pressure. And then people go through the construction site on one lane, and then all of a sudden, here is the void. This is the void. It's the low pressure. The low pressure. Once people see that there's open space and there's no more construction, then they zip on out. They zip on out. So this is the same kind of situation. You've got high pressure here, and it slowly moves, the air and the vehicles move slowly until they find the void, and then they go really fast. The same kind of thing. So we get an increase in speed toward the low pressure. Now I want to draw a cross section of what is happening here at the surface. Again, we have sinking air that creates a high pressure at the surface. That air then wants to find a void because it's tired of being next to another molecule. It moves to the low, increasing in speed. We know that the low at the surface is the result of warm air rising. So we'll put in the warm air that rises. When we consider the tropopause, this is the tropopause, the lid of the lower atmosphere, where is that air going to go now? The air's got to go someplace. So it's going to hit, it's like if you take a water balloon and you throw it up at the ceiling, what happens when it busts right at the ceiling? It spreads out. So we call this an area of divergence. So it moves out. And then when you come into an area where the air is more dense, then the air is converging. It converges. So an area of convergence allows that air to gain weight, to sink. It becomes cold and it sinks. This is how air compensates in the atmosphere. This is what we refer to as Dynes principle of compensation. Dynes principle of compensation. Dynes principle of compensation states that air must go someplace. So it's going to move in one location to fill the void. It's going to end up going up because the low pressure is warm. Then it hits an area of divergence, it's going someplace, and then it fills in the void here. This is an area of convergence and gains weight and sinks to continue this whole cycle.